Today is March 1st, which means it's the start of Women's History Month. Here in the Bay Area and across the country, events will be happening all month long, celebrating the vital role of women in American history. Joining us live now to tell us more about what we can all learn is Amy Simon, cultural historian, playwright, and performer. Thanks for joining us.
Happy to be here.
All right, Amy, you are a designated women's history expert. The Women's Media Center's resource, shesource.org, founded by Jane Fonda, Robin Morgan, and Gloria Steinem. First of all, that's a whole lot of strong women power there. But you tell us, how did this month-long celebration come about? How did it evolve?
It's a great story. It started in 1972, and in the 1970s, that was the beginning of the whole women's liberation movement, the second wave of feminism, but women had been fighting for equal rights for centuries. But in 1972, Molly McGregor was a social studies teacher here in Los Angeles, and a boy came up to her in her class and asked her, "What is the women's movement?" Because he had just seen the first issue of Ms. magazine. Now, Molly told me this whole story. She said she was so glad it was a Friday because she didn't know how to answer him. And she said, "Oh, I'll let you know on Monday." She goes home, she looks in the library, and she has one book. Meanwhile, she had been teaching a course in Sonoma State College called Sexism in Education. And she had asked her students to go into the library and do an analysis on women's history. Well, they found 3 to 5 books, and they hadn't been checked out in 15 years because they hadn't been signed, right? So she said a whole seed was planted. She brings this idea of Women's History Week to the Sonoma Commission on the Education Task Force on the Status of Women, and she brings them this idea to do a Women's History Week. So they have a parade. It goes great. They do it again the next year. She gets a bunch of publicity, and she gets invited to the Sarah Lawrence Institute in New York, headed by Gerda Lerner. Gerda Lerner was this major women's history icon. She created the first women's history program for colleges. The first one was in San Diego. I studied women's history in the 1970s in college, thanks to Gerda Lerner. Meanwhile, there were all these scholars there. They're very impressed with Molly McGregor's curriculum, and they hear about what she's done in Sonoma County. And there were very, as Molly put it, very prominent scholars there. Some of them were friends with Jimmy Carter. So cut to 1979, Molly has said she quit grad school and she created the National Women's History Project, which now is known as the National Women's History Alliance, NWHA.org. I encourage people to go visit that website. She tells me she'll never forget it. She's sitting in her office and she gets a phone call from the White House. It's Sarah Weddington. Now, if that name is familiar, Sarah Weddington was the 26-year-old Texas lawyer that represented Jane Doe for Roe v. Wade. But in 1980, she was Jimmy Carter's assistant, and she calls Molly McGregor to tell her that Jimmy Carter said, "Yeah, okay, let's do it. Women's History Week."
All right, so that is the story. Amy, I wish we had a whole lot more time, because now there's more than just 3 books, 3 resources. There's a whole lot more, including your play, She's History, which we saw little snippets of just there. Thank you so much for coming on to share that with us. We really appreciate it. Happy Women's History Month.
Happy Women's History Month.